red, one, multiplied, in this case, by two, equals two. I mean, this place was obviously some kind of math school. I'm inclined to just burn the thing to the ground, but it's just made of rock anyway. No math school, it's very bad. Well, I want to make sure I map out the walls and stuff, so I'm gonna walk along the perimeter and get this all mapped out. Can we look at this symbol? Oh! This is more involved. Did I look at that one? Wait. Is this supposed to be blue? Wait, is this, did we look at this one already? It's getting dark. And it looks like white. Okay, red, red, red. That's three. And then yellow. That's the same one. We've been here. This is blue, isn't it? This is the 150 equation. It just doesn't look blue there. Alright, so we've seen that one. Up ahead, this way we have not been. Right. Two reds times the orange is 10. Right. One and one. Times the orange is two. Equals 20. You know what? It made more sense if there was one orange. And one. Oh no, it's two. Right, this is two. And then this is multiplying. Never mind, it makes sense. The red and red are one each, that's two. And then multiplying the orange, which is 10, equals the 10 and 10, 20. I got this. I got this, baby. Right, let's see what else might be here. More equations. That's the same one. Red and red, yeah. This one is orange. One. Actually, no. Yeah. Is it red or orange? It looks orange. So 10 times 10 is 10. That makes no sense. It's orange, isn't it? Hold on, I want to directly compare. Maybe this is the red. It would make sense if it's the red. Because then this would be 1. And then this. You know what the problem is? It's just getting dark out, the colors change. So this is 1. Times. I don't even know. I think it's not looking right because it's. Alright, let's. Let's wait. Alright, and then let's rest. Just, does anyone need any more stuff back? No. Okay, we're just resting to rest. So we can see the colors better. Let's save a ration here. Did anyone carry her 88 rations? Walden? No, okay. So we still waste 2 rations. It's fine. Alright, it still looks orangish, doesn't it? Because if it's orange, then this is 10. I guess times itself. 10 times 1? That doesn't exactly make sense. I'm not sure if it's red or not. That's a problem. I guess it's red. It looks orange. But it kind of doesn't make sense for it to be orange, does it? It's red. Yeah, because this is the one I made an example of. And that's blue? It doesn't look blue right now. Alright, did I explore everything? Kinda giving up on this. Let's go over to this corner. I don't know what's going on there. If that's a way to go, or if it's just I didn't explore over there. That's red and that's orange. So the orange is definitely a paler. So it's red. This is red then. Figured I could make something that looks really red. Like the colors in the names, right? Is darker than this. So if it is red, then that's one. And then right, times 1 is 1. So that makes sense. So it's red. Good to know. Yeah, I should have figured so, because it being orange doesn't make sense with the equation there. Okay. Have we explored everything? Is there a secret? Because it's not exactly geometric shape we're dealing with here. There could be a space here. Let's go around and see. Oh wait! I fell through. Didn't mean to do that. Let's levitate back up. So wait a second. To the north. We can't walk that way. Let's just sidestep. See if there's something here now. Just trying to see if there are any secret rooms. We'll check down here, and then along here. Check these. And if nothing, then I'm done. I'll just leave this place. Leave this accursed place. Hopefully, they won't have missed everything, because I don't think there's a way back in here. As in the entire area. Around the corner here. I Who would ever think that we'd be on top of an old tower to the west with math problems? We're learning math, baby! This section here. Good thing we can't fall off the roof. At least I don't think we can. Try up here as well. That's most probably just the shape of the roof. We're not really in a dungeon, so I guess the regular laws don't apply here. Checked that wall already, so... Interesting how they don't show the hole. Not like on the floor down below, you can see the hole. How close do we get to this? Is this where it is? No. The east. Because if you go right up to it, you fall. Wrong area. You have to get closer. Says wrong area. But if we move forward, wait a second, maybe now we can do it. Nope, wrong area. Huh, I'm surprised. When we were like this before, it just let us fall. We still can't levitate. So we have to fall down, unless we use the rope, I guess. It doesn't cause much damage to us. Now to get out, we have to go back down and out that other way. Hopefully they've marked the spot on the map. This, I suppose. Hallway to the end and then make a right. I'm assuming the special is the way out. Might not be, but we'll try for that. If things move faster, it'd be easier to move like this. And figure out how to get a virtual, like, accelerator working. Graphics accelerator, whatever. Oh yeah, here it is. Okay. And just like that, we're out. Now we have to head all the way back. And fight Gizex. Because I didn't see that one. At least we have magic again. No CP time. Trying to do something here. Okay. Oh, they will come back up. You're getting like 6 points for this. Like getting no experience is the equivalent of like not learning anything from these battles. Like why do we learn so little from fighting these things? Yeah, 6. I'm gonna wait till it gets dark. Oh! As soon as you get close to the strange plant, its tentacles shoot out towards you. The tips of its branches burn like fire. We've always gotten close to these things, and they never did anything, we just couldn't get through them. Okay, Nelvin dies. Well, that's a new interesting... not so interesting development. I mean, we can resurrect him. Yeah, what's for dinner? Tentacles, apparently. He was kind of low on hit points, too. I'm just waiting till it gets dark out, and we'll rest. Because we need to rest. We might as well wait till it gets dark out. Ugh. These things were not doing that to us before. Maybe because we were using the disc. Maybe the disc stopped it. Oh, Sabine, wow. Who has the disc? Oh, she doesn't have it. I don't know who has it. Okay. Maybe this stops us from being attacked by those things, but just in case... Sabine's the only one who can resurrect people. Unless I think we use a staff, which I'm not even sure we have with us right now, so... let's just have her heal herself. It's good to be careful. We'll just heal everybody. And we'll get the mana back when we sleep. Good enough. Alright, so I think we can go out this way? Mm-hmm. Are these going faster? We're out of the swamp. We don't really... alright. Remove poison. I have 3 casts, but 5 people poisoned. I think we have some... remove poison, what do you call it? Potions. That didn't work for him? He's still poisoned? I guess he got double poisoned. And she's out, right? Yeah, she can't cast anything now. Except for Healing Hand. Probably gives you back 1 hit point. Alright, so healing cure poison. We have 7 of them here, right here. We never use these things. Here's 5 of them here. Like, his poise is not going away. Okay. Let's go. So we're let's just head east for a while and try to keep away from these things. Alright, we're gonna rest. If there's any doubt, we're heading back to the test mine, because now we know how to get through that door. Hopefully we've seen everything we needed to see, or would want to see, in the ruins. Kind of, because I thought the ruins was going to be our ultimate destination. But yeah, it turns out it might be the test mine. Alright, so let's rest. Let's see what we have. She needs, they could both use a healing. She's good. Needs one. One here. One here. And one here. Alright. Got one and one. 0, 1. Yeah. I want to get her a full mana, but I think we'll wait till we get to town to do that. Start heading southish. I don't want to overshoot the mark here. Oh! Gizax! Messed up. Now we gotta fight him. Thunderbolt hits a row of monsters. We'll try that. Effective. Is that because Nelvin's asleep? Yeah. Sleeping on the job again, aren't you? I don't think they appreciated the Thunderbolt. Thank you. I'll try not to run into more of these things. It's just a waste, but it's better to just defeat them than try to get away and have them damage us more and stuff like that. Actually, you're attacking this one. Nice hit, 17 and 19. Kind of a waste of a thunderbolt just on one enemy. But he was too slow. Throw a fireball at him. Never mind the thunderbolt. Alright. Let's try to go. I was gonna say home, but this really isn't home, is it? Oh! I'm by the water. Hold on a second. So I must be. Oh, it might not be this, it might be this river. Yeah, the way it's vertical like this, we've got to be here. So if we follow the river around, we'll run into the Dor Kiredon over there. Let us do that. Oh yeah, definitely a river. Ah, excellent. Don't run into more of them, I almost did it. This is a good lane to travel, apparently. There's like nothing in this path. Yep, I shout ahead. Alright, so to the tavern we go. Let's see if I can find out. Where we check in over here? I think it's on this side. We want to. You gotta make this place hard to traverse, don't you? Isn't it? I thought it was that. Maybe it's through here. No. I wish to avail myself of your sleeping area. In here? Thank you. And it was like a bar type area. So funny too, because when you're at an inn, you don't get that message saying that, you know, it would do no good to rest. It just lets you rest. Imagine that. now I want to find out how to get out of here. I should be here. Dark out. Doesn't matter for where we're going. The mine gate. Alright. That'll be next episode. We will find our way through. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.